There he is. Well, he looks cool, particularly in those shades.
Yeah, he's and he is cool. He's in great condition, the best condition of his life. And that was a spanner.
A lot of questions about Mo Farah, maybe. Just how much did that 10,000 metres take out of his legs? How fresh can he be as he looks ahead to this one? He's got to get through, first of all. Don't start hanging a medal around his neck already. He's got to qualify, and a lot can happen in the next 13 minutes or so. And then the final will be on Sunday, and great drama expected there. Farah back off the lead at the moment. You can see him running wide. Galen Rupp, who was in a qualifier from that, there he is. The qualifier from that first heat. He's watching on trackside just to see how well Mo Farah can run. They've become great friends.
Yes, they ran really well together in the Birmingham Diamond League. And in fact, after Mo Farah won that race, where Rupp finished his second, as Farah just closes in on the leaders, they went back to the track to do some training. Well, it's got to be as easy as possible here for Mo Farah. That savage finish in the 10,000 will have taken it out of him mentally and physically. But five fastest losers, and if anyone in this field, all top 10 here can qualify if they run inside 13:48. So Mo Farah can watch the field here. He doesn't have to finish in the first five. Probably he'll want to, but as long as the pace is inside 13:48, if he's in the top 10, he goes through, and he's got to do it as conservatively as possible.
But now the Ugandans are pushing on, and actually the Ugandans in the five and in the steeplechase are really becoming a little bit of a force within African athletics.
Running as a team, Jeffrey Kasuru and Abraham Kiplimo side by side, and just talking to each other as well as they came down the straight, just checking out how each other are feeling and what they're going to do, how he's going to take it on, what sort of pace.
But again, you can't kind of underestimate the fact that there are still, what, 18, 19 athletes in contention, and no matter how good you are, no matter how fast you are, things can change very, very quickly. And I guess for Mo, he's got to be concerned that someone doesn't make a break and he gets trapped. I don't think that'll be a problem for him, but again, here's one of the Ugandans making a little bit of a...
Yep, he didn't want to leave it any longer. There's Jeffrey Kasuru in this one for Uganda, and also Abraham Kiplimo, and Mo Farah just back into fourth place.
And he just needs to watch here that he doesn't get boxed on the inside. 11:09, so they're running outside the pace that would be fast enough to take those fastest loser spots at the moment, although I'm sure it will increase and burn up on the last couple of laps. But Mo just needs to work his way back onto the outside, and he does that now behind the two Ethiopians, very sensibly, finding himself in a little bit of an awkward position there tactically, and then moving up onto the outside. He's still exactly where he needs to be.
It's a little bit like a game of chess, and what Mo did then, he was stuck on the inside, he was slightly trapped. In the final, that might have been a problem. In the heat, he got plenty of time to get out. He just moved wide and put himself on the outside of the other athletes, keeping out of trouble. I was actually frustrated, the lap runners are not moving out, and that makes it even more difficult for the athletes in the front. But they're beginning to stretch the field now, beginning to create a bit of daylight, and five athletes might emerge from this relatively quickly.
Alistair Craig still in contention with that lead group. Got a number 9 on his hip. There he is in the green vest of Ireland, and a 62-second lap. That illustrates the extent to which the pace has been injected here. And as they come around towards the straight, that lead group is now turning more into a line. Athletes being dropped off the back, including Jake Robertson of New Zealand. And what a great camera shot that is as they come down the straight. Kipchoge from Farah. And on the inside, the Ugandan Kiplimo, as they go around now with less than 400 metres to go. And Farah takes them on in front, and he's going well now, cruising.
A similar tactic to Bernard Lagat in the last heat. We'll just wind it up now. We had 9 athletes in contention at the bell. We've now got down to what, effectively 6, and maybe a little bit of daylight from the front 4. So Mo is controlling it from the front. He'll be looking at the big screen, checking out where the rest are, and hopefully qualifying comfortably.
Imani Merger's gone with him, the Ethiopian who took the bronze in the 10,000 metres. and also for Ethiopia, Kuma, Abera Kuma, he's in the lead group. Kipchoge of Kenya there as well, and it looks as though Alistair Cragg is managing to hang on here, and it looks as though Cragg is going to qualify in the first five. The sprint's on now for the line, and you see there the power and the composure of Mo Farah. He goes up to the line and qualifies with safety with the two Kenyans, Merger and Kuma. Kipchoge through as well, and the winning time 13:37.96. Mo Farah going through with ease in second place, 55 second last lap, Dave.
Yeah, pretty astonishing. They made it look very comfortable, didn't they? And I'm delighted for Alistair Cragg making it through to the final. Good for Europe, good for Ireland.
Yeah, it's just not surprisingly poured a bottle of cold water over his head. These conditions are so hot. Mo, that looked comfortable. How are the legs after your silver medal winning exploits?
Yeah, I'm all right. The legs are all right. Got great teamwork. The physio's been great and just been resting.
Have you had any chance to enjoy what you did in the 10,000?
No, definitely, you know, I've just been relaxing with my wife and daughter. Other than just been chilling out, you know. Obviously, I wanted to come out here for 5K, so it's nice to get the heat out of the way and then see for the final.
You've been talking about that team you have around you. Alberto Salazar, your coach, who has done such great things with you this season. Galen Rupp stayed behind your training partner and watched the whole of that heat. How important are those people around you?
It's really important. Me and Galen got on well. You know, he's a great friend, not just a rival, but he's a mate of mine as well.
And are you doubly determined now, Mo, in the final of this 5,000 after coming so close to gold in the 10?
Yeah, it's not going to be easy, you know, but I'm going to go out there and give 110%, and that's all I can do.
I bet it is. I'm grateful for you and you're stopping now and your time.
No worries, thank you.